about to send you down twice as deep into hypnosis then. Let the audience applause and the beat burn to hypnosis. Second, I'm going to count to three. When I count to three, you're going to be at the beach, but you don't want to keep your eyes closed because the sun is awful high in the sky. And you don't want to burn those eyes. So in a second, I'm going to count to three. You'll be at the beach. You hear the sounds of the beach, the smells of the beach. But you're going to want to keep your eyes closed because the sun is high in the sky. And you don't want to burn those eyes. One, hearing those beach sounds. Two, smelling those beach smells. And when you get to that last number, you'll be at the beach, but you don't want to keep your eyes closed because the sun's all high in the sky. And three, at the beach. Ah, that's better. Nice and relaxing at the beach. As the sun starts to get higher in the sky, it does get a little bit warmer. If you'd like something to drink, hold out your hand. I'd be happy to give you something to drink. There you go. There you go. Oh, that's better. That's much better. There you go. There you go. Oh, sorry. There you go. The wind is actually starting to pick up now, and because you have already put suntan lotion on, that the wind as it starts to blow feels a little bit cooler than you were expecting. Like 80 degrees before. Now it's like 60 degrees. If you're seated next to somebody, you can lean onto that person as it gets colder and colder. Your ears like ice cubes on the side of your head. Your toes are so cold. If you're seated next to somebody, you could lean onto that person. One, two, three, one, wait. Oh, all right, we're gonna get started. We're gonna get started with the show, folks. Hold on a second. You just turn that off. What we're gonna do is we're gonna get started. I just need everybody listening to the sound of my voice. Everybody listening to the sound of my voice, sit up securely in your chair for me so we can get started. This show, the words coming out of my mouth, the most important thing you can hear right now. Everybody, ladies, pay attention. One, two, three, sweep now. Down. Let your body go loose, lift, and relax. All right. Just the person I'm tapping on the shoulder, open your eyes. I got a much more comfortable chair for you right there. Have you just lean to that? There you go. And who else? Anybody in the back here? Just a person tapping my shoulder. You can open your eyes. There's a much more comfortable chair for you right down there. Relax. Bam. Somebody help me. Okay, just the person I'm tapping on the shoulder. Tap her on the shoulder.
You can open your eyes.
Just the person I'm tapping on the shoulder. I got a chair for you. Here's a much more comfortable chair for you. Nest right up here.
Make room for
you. Please. And just these people will be given. Just there. But the audience applauds and them deeper.
Alright. So you just took a trip in your mind, a trip to the beach. And now you're about to win the automobile of your dreams.
If you'd like the keys to that dream automobile, hold out your hand. I'll give you those keys. Now, when I give you those keys, make sure you hide them because we are at the beach. There are thick pockets at the beach, so hide those keys in a safe place. There's the keys. Hide those keys in a safe place.
Alright.
Always smart. Alright.
So, why don't we go ahead and get ready? When I count to three, you're going to be in that seatbelt on from this point forward. You're always being the bell wearing your seatbelt even after the show. Go ahead and adjust that mirror. So when I count to three, you're going to be in that dream automobile now, listening to some of my voice. One, two, three. Go ahead and put the keys in the ignition. Put on some chains. Sorry, wrong station. Here's some music. If this wasn't your favorite song before. Alright. This is your favorite song now. You didn't realize how much you love this song until now. These windows are auto tints, so you can sing and dance and nobody will see. There things are in town. Out the window to your left, look at your best friend. Look out the window to your right, that person that's been flirting with you. Here's your favorite part of the song. You know it, you can sing to it. Feel compelled to sing now, here we go. Let's take this car on the highway. Skip 2 miles an hour. 70 miles an hour. 80 miles, 90 miles an hour.
That was a cop.
Oh, God.
All right. Go ahead. Take the next exit and pull over the parking lot.
You might be lucky here. Here's why. You recognize this police officer. This police officer likes to hear funny, creative excuses for speeding. And if you can give that police officer a funny, creative excuse for speeding, you might just get off that ticket. Now, obviously, it would be inappropriate to say anything other than the truth. But this is a special circumstance because this police officer knows. And as long as you can come up with a funny, creative, family-friendly reason for speeding, you might just get off that ticket. So, I'm going to come by. That's so important. I'm going to ask you why you're speeding. Can you please tell me why you're speeding?
I thought you were my parents and I was in trouble.
Right? Can you tell me why you're speeding?
My friend Jordan broke his foot.
A chicken had a
Happy birthday to your chicken. How old's your chicken?
Four.
What do you get a chicken for its birthday?
Eggs.
Okay. It's an inspirational present. Okay. Can you please tell me why you're speeding?
So really funny. My friend Brianna had a poo.
Can you please tell me why you're speeding?
My friend Colin, his dog has got three legs.
Can you please tell me why you're speeding?
I always speed.
Can you please tell me why you're speeding?
I was going to your mother's house.
My mom.
Okay. Can you please tell me why you're speeding?
My dad's in the hospital.
Okay. Pass. Can you please tell me why you're speeding?
To get my dog to the hospital.
Please tell me why you're speeding.
Okay, so it's kind of a story, but I was just on the highway and I saw this baby on the side of the road, and I'm like, I can't just leave this baby. So I put him in my car, and it turns out he had a dirty diaper, and it was just a mess in the back seat. And I'm just trying to get him to the nearest foster home. So, I'm sorry, I'm just trying to be a good guy.
I mean, you were being a good Samaritan, so I suppose. Can you please tell me why you're speaking?
A Fortnite guy. I get the dub.
One more time.
Fortnite.
Dub. Please tell me why you're speeding.
My goat was giving birth.
Your goat is giving birth? How many?
Six.
Oh gosh. Alright. One more time. Please tell me why you were speeding.
My mom fell in the street.
Okay. Let the audience of ours send them deep. Well, you're in luck because you pulled into a parking lot of a movie theater. That's right. The second, I count to three, you're about to see the funniest movie you've ever seen. When that movie starts, the more you laugh, the better you feel, the more you want to laugh. But if I was to ever say the word popcorn, you will smell the worst smell you've ever smelled in your life. You'll be convinced that it's coming from your neighbor. And it won't make you sick, it won't make you throw up, you will not touch your neighbor, you'll be convinced that the smell is coming from your neighbor. But only if I say that word. Second count three, do you see that movie together? One, I'm getting ready to see the funniest movie you've ever seen. Two, you will not feel better, you will not feel better, you will not. And three, we just got twice as much. wanted a popcorn?
Smells good, and the more you smell your neighbor's shoulder, the more that bad smell goes away. What's that smell like? What's that smell like, miss? 1, 2, 3, wide awake. All right, we're gonna get started with the show. I need everybody to sit. In the back of their chairs. Sit firmly in your chairs, listening to the sound of my voice. Look right here. You need everybody to look right here. Just looking right here. And sleep now. Let your body loose. Lift. And relax with the audience applause and then deeper into the. Makes you smile, makes it difficult now for you not to smile because you can't help but smile as you start to feel even better now. Count to three, just the person I'm tapping on the shoulder. You'll be wide awake, you'll take a seat out in the audience and enjoy the show out in the audience, laughing and having a great time the rest of the evening. 1, 2, and 3. All right, let's give her a big round of applause. Just the person I'm tapping on the shoulder, you can hear me snap my fingers. Just the person I'm tapping on the shoulder, you'll be wide awake, excited, happy. I want to take a seat out in the audience, enjoy the rest of the show. 1, 2, and 3. Thank you for volunteering, miss. We're going to take a seat out in the audience. Give her a big round of applause. I think we're good out in the audience now, right? Nobody else is. Just the person I'm tapping on the shoulder. There's going to be an empty chair to your left, a couple chairs over. Just go ahead and take that empty chair for me. We'll sit down in the empty chair. Walk very carefully. Open your eyes and look and see the chair. See it? There you go. Go ahead and sit down, safe and secure. Sleep. Well, we did have a problem with that movie reel. Unfortunately, that movie reel, it jumped the reels. We're going to have to change the reel. In the meantime, we're going to have to pass some time. What we're going to do that is we're going to conduct a celebrity interview. On three, snap my fingers. You'll open your eyes and you'll look, and you'll be convinced the person holding the microphone is your absolute favorite male movie star. You'll be completely surprised. You had no idea they were planning this surprise for you tonight. But yes, indeed, the person holding the microphone is your absolute favorite male movie star. Now, there's a couple of rules. One, you will not be able to leave your chair unless I give you permission. And you will not be able to touch the male movie star. Those are two very important rules. That's not my most important concussion. You'll be convinced the person holding the microphone is your absolute favorite male movie star. We'll conduct a celebrity interview. You can introduce me to everybody. Now, if you see somebody up on stage introducing a movie star that you don't see that's holding the microphone, it'll make sense to you later, doesn't matter. But I am your absolute favorite male movie star. 1, 2, and 3. All right, we're going to start. Hey, everybody. Congratulations! So what we're going to do now is we're going to conduct a celebrity interview. I'm going to ask you some questions. You can ask me some questions. I'll have that opportunity. Just make sure the questions are appropriate. Okay, just want to make sure you get it. I don't want to make it sound.
Miss, would you like to introduce me to everybody and ask me a question? Okay, let's see. Why don't you introduce me to everybody?
Stoned Up.
And what's your favorite movie? Well, you know, I'm filming yet another Pirates of the Caribbean. Would you like to have a role in that?
Yes!
What, you actually get to choose your own part. Which part would you like?
I don't know.
Well, I'll have you talk to my agent. Would you like your picture taken with me?
Yeah.
Okay. Who's going to be the official photographer and I can upload this to Facebook right away and tag her and say, look, it's her with Johnny Depp. Who's going to do that for her? You? Okay, come on. Come on up. This is not like an on camera or a phone. This is a real phone. Okay. You need a official photographer and then this next picture. Outstanding. Thank you. Have a seat. Thank you very much. Sir, go ahead and stand up. Why don't you introduce me to everybody?
This is Will Ferrell.
What's your favorite movie?
I have a lot of favorite movies here, man. It's awesome. It's got Brothers, Other Guys.
The Other Guys was awesome. That was one of my favorites. I did all my own stunts in that.
Oh, man. And the Witches. And the Witches. Lions, you know, they're like freshwater. They don't like saltwater.
That's a good point. That's a good point. All right, here we go. Let's go get our picture taken. I'll let you stand right here. Make sure you tag him and me in it. All right. Have a seat. Thank you, sir. Miss, come on up. Introduce me to everybody.
Are you really Thor?
I am.
Very, I am, my lady.
Would you like to be in the next Thor movie?
Sure.
Well, you don't have to. It's okay.
Can I just watch?
Absolutely, yeah. All right, you want your picture taken? All right, do it like a Thor pose. Outstanding. Thank you. Sir, you're next. All right, introduce me.
This is Robert Downey Jr.
Outstanding. This is, did you see Infinity Wars?
Yeah.
What'd you think? You want to be in the next one?
Yeah.
Which character do you want? Hulk. Do a Hulk pose. He's going to take a picture. Ready? All right, go ahead. Outstanding. Yes, come on. Hi, how are you?
Great.
Would you introduce me to everybody?
This is John Krasinski.
Outstanding. Why don't you take a picture? All right. Sir.
Judge Chris Pratt.
That's right. I guess a lot of people see the video. Did you see it? No? Miss, come come on up. Why don't you introduce me, everybody?
This is Post Malone.
Who? Post Malone. I'm gonna get my picture taken. Okay, why don't you introduce me, everybody?
This is Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yes. Favorite movie?
The Great Gatsby.
Yeah, that was it. I enjoyed making that movie. We're making The Great Gatsby, too. It's like a zombie movie. The zombie movie, yeah. It takes place right after. You want to be in it? Cool, all right. Well, I'll have my agent talk to you. Why don't you introduce me?
Morgan Freeman.
You want your picture taken? Go ahead and smile. Alright, do me a favor. Just turn around and look at your seat before you sit in. I just want to make sure you can see it. Sit. Go ahead and see. Yeah, I know, you moved chair earlier, but I didn't realize that. Sir, come on.
You're Al Pacino.
What's your favorite movie? Scarface.
Oh my gosh.
We're making a Scarface too.
No, you're not.
Yes.
I can't.
It wasn't actually cocaine in the movie. It was magical powder from Hogwarts. It's like a Hogwarts Scarface mashup.
So the bullets weren't.
I got shot a lot. You want to be in a movie? Yeah. All right. Well, let's get our picture taken. Give me a save my name. Action. anytime anybody shakes your hand for the rest of the night, it seems that they've told you the funniest joke you've ever heard in your life. Now that feeling of you wanting to laugh just only might last a second. And it won't work with the same person twice in a row. If some of you guys just keep shaking your hand. So, if anybody was to shake your hand the rest of the evening, it seems that somebody's told you the funniest joke you've ever heard in your life. That feeling of wanting to laugh, but it won't last about a second. You don't know why you're doing that, but it'll just feel good to laugh. Let's see. And just the person tapping on the shoulder now. You want to get up at the right count of five, but you will be stuck in your chair. You're not sure why you're stuck in your chair. You're not going to be able to get out of your chair if I was just tapping my fingers behind you three times. Just that person. If you ever hear me say the words parents, you'll feel the uncontrollable urge to yell, "We love you." If you ever hear me say those words. Now, remembering what happens when somebody shakes your hand, remembering if you ever hear me say the parents, what you're supposed to do. And forgetting everything that happened to you up here on stage here tonight, until you have a drink of your choice or until I tell you. Oh. One more thing. I will still be your absolute favorite and movie star, even after you come wide awake. Unless you get about 5 feet away from me, and then I return to my own self, and you'll be kind of disappointed. So I can relive the next world. Here we go. One, remembering those things I ask you to remember. Two, forgetting those things I ask you to forget. Three, you becoming more and more awake, aware, excited. Of energy for you when I get the last number, you'll be wide awake. Remembering those things I ask you to remember, forgetting those things I ask you to forget, and wide awake. Here we go. So, do me a favor as you open your eyes now, wide awake. Raise your hand if you don't think you're hypnotized. I won't be offended. We can try it again. If you don't think you're hypnotized, raise your hand. I feel a little tired, but you've had a long night. That's fine. Don't make your hands. What am I doing over this chair, right? Hey, thanks for volunteering. Remember what happened to somebody? Thank you. That's good. Thanks for volunteering. All right. Thank you for volunteering. I appreciate it. Let's hear it for our volunteers. Just take a seat out. Make sure you shake everybody's hand. Together tonight.
We love it.